watching Game Show Network. You're watching Game Show Network.
Favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by New Sarbet, America's leading spray deodorant. The lotion spray deodorant that's like balm to your skin. Boom! There goes perspiration. Now let's all play What's My Line?
Now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And on my left, a brilliant wit and humorist and doll, Fred Allen.
Thank you, Arlene. Say, John, before we get started, I think there's something that we should settle once and for all. I have a letter here from a lawyer in Buffalo. This gentleman is a Buffalo lawyer. And it says, "Dear sir, at the opening of each Sunday seance, each panelist opens with the words, 'On my left.' Now, physically, I wouldn't mind having any of the female members on my left arm, but I am wondering if it shouldn't be 'at my left' in this connection. Very truly yours, Matthew X. Wagner." Now, should it be on my left or at my left?
This is a very serious decision to make, and I think we ought to have a little prior consultation before I answer you directly.
Maybe you have to look it up.
Well, since I've heard from my lawyer, my Buffalo lawyer, he also handles people, too. I will say on my, at my left, rather, is Miss Mary Healy.
And on my left, at my left, is a man who gives great parties. We went to one last night, and Peter and I decided that you should no longer be a panelist, that you should be an entertainer after your performance. This is Bennett Suh.
Charming faker, but I thought you and Peter were wonderful on Ed Morrow's show the other night.
Thank you, Bennett.
And at my left is not only a great news analyst and panel moderator, but a past master and a present master of obfuscation, Mr. John Charles Daly.
Thank you, Mr. Sir. And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Nobody's at, near, or on me, so we'll welcome you to What's My Line. And I think we're going to have a little trouble with the panel tonight. But in turn, we'll try to give the panel some trouble tonight with some very interesting occupations and some very nice people who've brought the occupations with them. A little later on, we'll have a famous guest challenger, but let's let these experts of ours, who are throwing so much English about at us tonight, meet the first challenger. Would you sign in, please, sir? William Draper, is that right, sir?
That's correct.
And a very firm and bold hand. Where are you from, sir?
Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio.
Cuyahoga?
That's right.
Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio.
That's correct.
Well, it's nice to have you here with us. And it's our custom to let the panel have a small time, a small chance, as it were, to know you a little bit better before they have to start asking questions. So would you take a hike down in front of the panel for me?
What city is that near, man?
Near Akron.
Near Akron?
Yes, sir.
How do you do?
Has Bennett lectured at your town? Cuyahoga Falls.
Get there next to you.
All right, Mr. Draper, if you will, sir, over here and sit down next to me. And it is our custom now to let the folks at home and those who are here in the theater with us know immediately what your line is, and then we'll let the panel see what they can work out along this line, as it were. Mr. Draper, do you know how we score this operation?
I have a good idea.
You have a good idea. Well, let's see if we can flip a few cards then. I will just announce that you're salaried, and we'll begin the general questioning with Miss Arlene Francis.
Mr. Draper, are you by any chance a professional man?
I am.
You have letters after your name?
I have not.
No, actually, I would say there that with Mr. Draper's permission, I was going to intercede earlier that we have a general classification when we use the word professional man, which might have misled Miss Francis, and
it
so
did.
We would give you a... when you said, are you a professional man, we'd have given you the no then.
I see. Thanks, Lowe.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Allen.
Do you deal in services, Mr. Draper?
Would you say again?
I rarely repeat, but I will in this
example.
I never have a chance to repeat. I'm always knocked off before I can repeat anything. Do you deal in services?
I do.
Are these services available for men and women?
They are.
Do the people come to you for these services?
Yes, they do.
There was a little time wasted on making up your mind. Do you perform these services in an office?
No, I don't.
That's two down and eight to go, Miss
Healy. No office, eh? Well, that's too bad.
Do you perform these services on the ground?
No.
Underground?
No. On the ground.
Oh, on the ground. Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Draper, have you got anything to do then with the aviation industry?
I have.
That's what I thought.
Would it be possible that you are employed by the United States government?
It is.
Do you sometimes wear a uniform?
I do.
Are you a commissioned officer?
I am.
In aviation?
That's correct.
Are you stationed anywhere near Cuyahoga Falls?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis. Now, actually, you have determined
you
a great deal. You have determined
you
that, yes, that Mr. Draper is a commissioned officer and in the aviation area, but there's a special classification for you to go after here.
Well, if you're off the ground, I presume that there must be some piloting to do with your work. Is this Mr. Draper, or Lieutenant Draper?
There is.
How do you know he's a lieutenant?
I don't know that he's a lieutenant. I just threw that out.
Would you like to ask that question
specifically? No, I'm not taking any chances with you anymore. Are you a special kind of pilot, Mr. Draper? Do you pilot a special type plane? Is that it?
Well, I will say that there is a special classification in a way, although it would not necessarily be within the framework or term of reference that applies to Air Force classifications of pilots. There is a special identification which is unique to Mr. Draper, yes.
I don't remember my question now. Well, are you perhaps, are you associated with jet planes in any way?
I'm not.
No, that would make it five down and five to go.
Mr.
Are you active in as a pilot as of now?
I am.
And you're not in jet work?
No, I'm not.
Are you involved in any atomic fandangling that's currently going on?
Not primarily.
Not primarily.
Six down and four to go, Miss Healy.
Is this this plane that you navigate? No, you don't navigate. Are you a pilot?
I'm a pilot.
Would this happen to be a special type of plane?
Well, it's a special type of plane without particularly having reference to its scientific or technical
Mary,
classification.
You should know better by now.
See?
It's your second week. What? No. Well, I think perhaps it might be a plane that has the propeller on the top.
Helicopter.
A helicopter?
Helicopter.
Oh, that's fine. Seven down and three to go, Mr.
Draper, would you possibly be the pilot of a very important person in the United States government?
I am.
The most important person?
I consider so.
Are you President Eisenhower's pilot?
That's right, sir. Just to make Arlene feel a little bit better, I would like you to meet Colonel William Draper of Cuyahoga Falls. Yes, Fred.
That should make him feel better, I
guess. I was going to say, where's the golf bag?
Now, actually, I would like to ask one question, if I can ask this and get an answer without invading discretion in your area, sir. How is the president as a flyer? I know he's always had great interest in aviation, always. Does he come up in the cockpit and handle the controls once in a while, for instance?
Occasionally, yes. And I'll just say that he's a wonderful passenger.
He's a wonderful
passenger? Very wonderful passenger, yes, sir.
Well, he's a very wonderful man, we can put it that way. And thanks very much, sir, for being our guest.
Nice to have you.
Well, very good start, panel. Let's see what you can do now with a second challenger. This time we may trip you up. Will you come in and sign in, please, ma'am? Grace? Grace Bright, is that right? And is it Miss or Mrs.?
Mrs.
Mrs. Bryce, and Mrs. where are you from? Miss?
Mrs. Bryce.
Mrs. Bryce, and where are you from, Mrs. Bryce?
Sherman, Texas.
Sherman, Texas. Well, nice to have somebody from Texas with us. It's been raining down that way. Is that your part of the country where
that's
all the
right.
rains have been? But you wanted the rain, but not that much all at once. Is
that's
that the
right.
idea? Well, let's put a little sunshine in the lives of our four friends over there. Will you take a small hike down there so that they can get a better look at you, please?
West Texas, East Texas.
No. One southerner to another, I'm from Louisiana.
I'm from no place, Miss Bryce.
All right, Mrs. Bryce, over here and sit down next to me, if you will. And the first job that we'll do is to let the folks at home and those who are here in the theater with us know what your line is before we let the panel try to find out what it is by a certain amount of judicious questions. You know how we score this operation, do you?
Yes, I
Fine.
Do.
Fine. Then with no more ado, we'll announce that you're self-employed and begin the general questioning with Bennett, sir.
Well, Mrs. Bryce, you know the mayor of Fort Worth is sitting right down the front row tonight. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know
is,
that.
Is Sherman anywhere near Fort Worth?
About 65 miles or 70.
Should give him a no answer for that.
In Texas, that's not that's next door.
That's next door in
that's
Texas.
That's right.
Is there a product involved with what you do?
Yes, it is.
Is it a useful product?
Yes, it is.
Is it a product that is used by both men and women?
Yes.
Is it an economic product? Something that they can obtain for a reasonable amount of money? Now, in Texas, that may not mean the same thing as it does up here. I mean, that means less than $1 million.
That's right.
Is it a household product?
Yes, it is.
Is it used inside the house?
That's right.
Is it used in any special part of the house?
No.
Well, now, small conference.
That's a big conference for Texas, I guess.
I think Mrs. Bryce agrees with me that since you put the question as you did, we would be unfair to give you a flat no, so we will give you a qualified yes.
In other words, Mrs. Bryce, it's used usually in one part of the house. More often than other times in one part
yes,
of the house.
Its use is restricted in general to, let us say, some area of the house rather than another area.
Would that room where it is generally used be the kitchen?
Yes.
Is your product edible?
Yes.
Is it edible by men and women?
Yes.
Is it vegetable?
Yes.
Good, I can't get off of that. Is it something that grows in Texas?
Yes.
You can't eat oil, can you? Is it got anything to do with the alfalfa family?
No.
No. 1 out of 9. 9 to go, Miss Francis.
If it were served at dinner, could it be served at dinner to begin with?
Yes.
Yes. Would it be considered in the dessert family at all?
No.
Ooh. Ooh. 2 down to 8 to go, Mr. Allen.
Can you eat it with butter?
Can you eat it with butter?
Yes.
I suppose you can eat it with butter, yes. But rather than revolt the whole civilized world, we'll say you shouldn't and give you a no. 3 down to 7 to go, Miss Healy.
Is it, am I right in assuming that this is particularly eaten in the South more than anywhere else?
No.
No. 4 down and 6 to go, Mr. Sir.
Is this usually served hot?
No.
5 down, 5 to go, Miss Francis.
May I ask if this is more an accessory to a meal than the main course? Would it be in the condiment family? I mean, like pickles or piccalilli, that sort of thing.
Yes, I think we could describe it as being in the condiment family,
Well, if you wouldn't eat butter on it, you wouldn't eat butter on pickles. Unless they were bread and butter pickles, of course. Well, is it some kind of relish? Did we relish it? A conference for a relish? What do they put in them in Texas?
We are willing to admit that this might be generally described as being in the relish area, and we rather relish that reply.
Well, you mean I have to get away from what we think of as pickles and pickleelli? It isn't quite that. Is that, that's what you're saying?
Well, if you want to ask the question, is it pickles, we'd be happy to have you ask the question.
I asked you if it was in the pickles or pickleelli family, and you said yes.
No, we haven't had that specific question from you yet. Would you like to ask that question?
No. I'll move away from him. Is it horseradish?
No. 6 out of 4 to go, Mr. Allen.
Well, is it pickles?
Yes. Oh, my. Now, actually, all you have to do now, Mr. Allen, is tell us what relation Mrs. Bryce has to pickles.
She's a pickle packer?
No.
No.
7 out of 3 to go, Miss Healy.
She grows pickles?
8 down and 2
no.
to go, Mr. Serve.
She bottles pickles.
Well, I think we might have to agree to that, wouldn't we? You do bottle pickles.
That's right.
Actually, Mrs. Bryce owns a pickle factory, and they do bottle pickles. Thank you very much. You have a lovely time. Good night. Good to see you. And let the mayor of Fort Worth note that Texas distinguished itself before this panel tonight. We'll meet for the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which my friends on the panel, as always, are blindfolded. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, Mr. Yes,
good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Mystery challenger, we get right down to the general questioning, and under the new rules, you ask one question at a time in turn, and we move clockwise. We will begin the questioning with Miss Healy.
Are you in the entertainment business?
Yeah.
Mr. Seth?
Would that entertainment ever include the moving picture world?
Yeah.
Are you a leading man?
Yeah.
A low one.
Are you Peter Lynn Hayes?
No.
1 down and 9 to go, Miss Healy.
Are you any one of them?
Are you, particularly... I heard a lot of whistles. I thought for a while it might be a girl, but... are you particularly appealing to the Bobby Sox?
Well, to save our guests from embarrassment, I will say that it's my understanding that he holds very high estate among the Bobby Soxes, yes. But he has a very large company beyond and above the Bobby Soxes in his train.
Well?
My turn.
Yes. I wondered what happened.
Are you in New York on business?
Yeah.
Are you in a picture that is playing now, presently?
Yeah.
Are you Van Johnson?
Yeah.
I'm just going for getting the names after this. I'm not fooling them.
Well, as you all know, we had Van with us once before, and it was one of those unhappy occasions when advance notice of his appearance on the show crept out, and he just came out, and we had to say, well, here he is, and it's nice to see him, but we couldn't have any guesswork on it. Tonight, it looks like with this Allen around...
Well, I saw Van playing tennis with James Mason two months ago, and that's how it clicked in my mind.
He's fooling around Central Park now, aren't you, Van?
Yeah.
You still got those red socks on?
Oh.
You know, Bennett, that's why I didn't go to your house for the weekend, don't you?
Is that it?
How was I going to get out of the house to do What's My Line without letting you know?
You mean you missed the party last night because of this?
Yeah.
And that Fred Allen, you know, really, not... You shouldn't do that.
Well, I sleep in Central Park, and I know that Van's been making a picture.
Which bench? I didn't know we were neighbors.
Well, next to Bonnie Baruch, number two.
What is the picture you're shooting now, Ben?
Thank you. I'm supposed to get that plug in for Warner Brothers, a picture called Miracle in the Rain with Jane Wyman and Eileen Heckett. By Ben Hecht.
And what's it called?
Miracle in the Rain.
I thought we'd give you two for Warner Brothers, because there are two brothers.
But the only thing I've seen so far is pictures of Van in Central Park with the sun shining. What are you going to have to do, wait for the rain to come?
That's the miracle. That comes next week.
Guarantee you might even get it this week, sir. But it was, I must say, some sunshine for us that you came to be our guest.
Thanks very much, Ben.
Wonderful to see you. Will you say goodnight to the panel? Panel, you were almost brilliant tonight, but perhaps we can trip you up yet. Let me get back to ground zero here and then ask another challenger to sign in, please. Ramona Detmeyer, is that right?
Dietemeyer.
Dietemeyer. Nice to know you. Is it Miss or Mrs.?
Mrs.
It's Mrs.
Yes.
Mrs. Dietemeyer. Well, we have so little time left, I'd ask you to look at the panel.
No, I
think that's more than I should have asked you. Now come with me, please, and we will dispense with the walk down and save that time. And all we'll do right now is follow custom and let the folks at home and those here in the theater know what your line is, but then see if the panel can work it out the hard way. All right? You know how we...
Maybe on purpose to tell us where Mrs. Dietemeyer comes from.
Oh, we'd be glad to let you know. Where does Mrs. Dietemeyer come from?
From Lincoln, Nebraska.
From Lincoln, Nebraska. And you know how we score this, Mrs. Dietemeyer?
Yes, I do.
Good. Then we will just announce that you are salaried, and since Fred Allen is so sharp tonight, let him start the general question.
Sharp around the head, John. Do you, Miss Dietemeyer, do you deal in services, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, you are very attractive, if you don't mind my saying so.
Thank you, Fred.
Would good looks have anything to do to enable a girl to sort of get in the profession in which you are in?
Yes.
Looks, no, I would say they help, Fred.
Looks are helpful.
No, but this is to presume, you know, that appearance always plays a part in acquiring any particular place or position. You know?
John, if you have to... If you ever have to eat your words, you'll be at them all day long. That'll be the longest meal in history. Well, tell me, if looks are important, do you deal with the opposite sex?
Yes.
Do you deal with them singly rather than in groups?
Small conference.
Well, like a manicurist. I mean, one...
We have had an earnest conference, and the question was, deal singly, and we would have to say there, no. So that's one down and nine to go, Miss Seeley.
You deal with men and ladies. In this service that you perform, do you wear a uniform?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Dietemeyer, besides looking like Sonya Henning, which you do, you know.
Thank you.
You also look like a lot of lovely ladies I've seen in and around the aviation industry. Have you anything whatever to do with that?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
Do you speak in your job? I don't mean just yes or no. I mean, do you stand before people and speak?
You mean appearing before audiences, in effect?
Yes, not big ones, small ones.
Small audiences, 10 or 15 people, perhaps.
John, you've got your heart.
Let's just give her a no, anyway. All right. One out of six to go, Mr. Allen.
Now, where... you work in a place, I assume. Is there food and drink served in the place where you work?
Yeah.
Is there?
Yeah.
Well, after a hard day at the office, would a fellow be inclined to stop in at your place for a little drink?
I wish we had more time, Fred. The answer to that would be yes. Mr. Dietemeyer gets the full prize because we've run out of time, and we've done something we wanted to do for a long time. Mrs. Dietemeyer is a housewife. In fact, she is Mrs. America of 1955. And she is 56. I'm sorry. And she has a lovely family. And she serves food and drink to a lovely family. How many youngsters altogether?
Five, John.
Five children. You see, isn't that wonderful? And we're so happy that you made it here because we had a little airplane trouble and she just flew in. Thanks very much for being
Thank
our
you,
guest
John.
On What's My Life.
Nice to have you.
And you all know Dorothy Kilgallen is in Europe on vacation. We have missed her, but she'll be here next week. And so tonight, for the last time, I guess, because we'll be changing positions again, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Arlene.
Thank you, John. Good night.
Good night, Van Allen.
Thank you, Arlene. Good night, Mary. Godspeed to New Rochelle.
Thank you, and good night, Bennett. I'll miss you all.
We'll miss you.
We'll miss you. We're glad to have Dorothy back. We're going to miss you. Good night, John.
And good night, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
Transportation for What's My Line is arranged through American Airlines, America's leading airline, serving 77 major cities throughout the United States.
Get away from...
The battlefield for a game of speed and strategy. These are the letters that lead to victory on Blockbusters! Here's the star of our show, Bill Cullen!
Thank you. Thank you all very much. I love it. Hello, bud. Oh, thank you. That's all right, son. Hi there. Hey, thank you very much, and welcome to Blockbusters. I want to thank Bob Hilton, our very fine man here. People say, what does Bob Hilton do on the show? Nothing. He walks in at the very last minute and says, welcome to Blockbusters, and now he's all done. Thank you, Robert, for a job well done. This is a game, you know, where a family pair competes against a solo player, and it's up to them to see who wins the game. Our last winner and current champion is that solo player. May I introduce Chuck Logue, who so far has won $13,600.
Hiya, Bill.
Good going, Chuck. You really, you're a fine player.
Thank you.
Tell everybody about you so they catch up, you know, people who haven't been watching us of late.
Yeah, I'm a teacher. I've been teaching for 22 years. I'm teaching sixth grade now. I've taught everything from third grade through junior college.
Yeah.
I'm a theater nut. Uh-huh. And my son just told me yesterday he... proposed to his girlfriend, and she said, well, think about it.
Isn't that nice? Isn't it? All those years of teaching, I bet, now you have 13,600, you've spent, how much time up here would you say, like an hour and a half or 2 hours?
About 2 hours.
All right. That's better than teaching, isn't it?
A little better, yeah.
A little better. Would you like to meet the family pair?
I'd love to.
They are a delightful looking, and would you believe, I don't believe, it is a mother and daughter combination.
No, sisters.
They are sisters. It's Phyllis Henderson and her daughter, or sister, Pam Clark. Welcome, you two. Good to have you both. Hi, Pam.
Hello.
I bet people always tell you about how young your mother looks, huh?
Yeah, well, she's the one that tells me how young she looks.
She has to watch her own interests. Tell us about you, Pam.
Well, I live in Del Mar, California. Uh-huh. I've been married a year and a half to a great guy. We have 2 12-pound little kitties, and I work at UCSD in the physics department.
You have 2 12-pound kitties or kitties?
Cats.
Oh.
But they're my little kitties.
I thought you had new twins or something.
No.
How about you, Phyllis? What do you want us to know?
Well, I live in Brigham City, Utah, right next door to Vicki Jensen. She told me to say that.
Oh, Vicki Jensen told you. Who, pray tell, is Vicki Jensen, Phyllis? I want to be up on these things.
She's just my next-door neighbor.
Okay, I want to know things like that. What else is new in your life?
Well, in June, my husband and I will be married 35 years.
Uh-huh.
I have 2 sons and a daughter.
Uh-huh.
And 2 of my hobbies are gardening and corny jokes.
Gardening and corny jokes?
Yes.
Corny.
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 Beginning with the letter C.
Yes.
Would you like to tell a short one?
Oh, I'd love to.
Please do. Please do. Let me do this. Ladies and gentlemen, Phyllis Henderson is now about to regale you with a joke.
There were, applause.
Milk it, Phyllis. Get it? Now, there you go.
There were two surgeons getting ready for surgery, abdominal surgery, and the surgeon made an incision, and he pulled out a big bouquet of flowers. And the assistant said, "My gosh, where did that come from?" And the surgeon said, "Gee, I don't know. There isn't any card."
Vicki Jensen, your neighbor is going to be home a lot sooner than you expected. That was good, Phyllis. Thank you. You will from time to time tell us those, will you not?
I'd love to.
If you don't mind, now we'll hasten into our game, if for no other reason than to change the subject. It's a brand new game now. We're going to begin this one with a letter B. Family pair is going to work side to side.